Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen. Spirit.
In the waters of baptism, John died with Christ and rose with Christ to new life. May he now share with Christ eternal glory. In baptism, John was clothed with a white garment as a symbol of his Christian dignity and purity. May he take this white garment forth with him to enter into the kingdom of heaven. In baptism, John received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death.
Life. I didn't have the honor to know him as you did, fathers. I just came here recently. But Jesus said that for his fruits, you will know him. For me, it was enough meeting with you guys, the family, just for 10, 15 minutes to realize that your dad is a great man. God bless his soul. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant John, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever.
Because God tried them found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. And as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine. And they shall dart about as sparks through stone. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples. And the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth. And the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones. And his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
news according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you welcomed me. Naked, and you clothed me. Ill, and you cared for me. In prison, and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?' And the king will say to him, to them in reply, 'Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for the least of my people, you did for me.' Then he will say to those on his left, 'Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison, and you did not care for me.' Then they will answer and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or ill or in prison and not minister to your needs?' He will answer them, 'Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me.' And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life." My friends, the gospel, the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise
be to
you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. I would like to begin with a word of gratitude to the Bertles family. I cannot begin to tell you how honored I am for the invitation to be with you this morning to celebrate John's life. And it is a special blessing to be invited to offer a few words of reflection on the readings that you have chosen to celebrate a great and wonderful life, a life very well lived. And I have to confess that I'm having some flashback of Loretta's funeral. And I am delighted to be with my brother priest. I would like to especially thank Father Jorge for his gracious hospitality, and Father Allen for being here from Guardian Angels in Mead. And it's always a delight to be with Father Simeon, a former pastor here at Holy Cross. And I have only one regret about my concelebrant. I wish Tom Coit were here because he needs to be reminded that I'm the favorite. Wisdom and from the letter to the Corinthians, and as I was proclaiming the Gospel of Matthew, I had a thought. This afternoon, I'm going to go home, and I'm going to see if I can get the New American Bible online. The New American Translation is the one we typically use for liturgies, and I'm going to see if they have a Google app. And I'm going to type in the search line, John Francis Bertles. And I'll bet these readings pop up. Because they certainly echo and describe the man whose life we celebrate today. Long before John ever knew the gift of light, 90-some years ago, our God inspired the sacred writers to describe him for us. Sometimes, as I listen to the scriptures or as I read them, it is helpful to have a point of reference, something you can use as a help to understanding. And may I suggest that John Francis is the point of reference for these readings that we have just heard, for they do indeed describe him well. All of us in this room have our own personal memories of John. As a former pastor here at Holy Cross, I remember how deeply devoted he and Loretta and the Bertles family have been to Holy Cross for so many, many years. I can still see John in the lot outside at the bazaar at the festival. I can still see him working the penny pitch and the putt-putt booth. And my best memory of John and Loretta both, but in these last years, John especially, his faithfulness to daily Eucharist. He was always here, and he was always attentive, a man of deep prayer, a man of deep faith. And I'm convinced, actually, the community of Holy Cross taught me this, that the vibrancy and the holiness of a parish community has much more to do with its members than any of us who happen to, for a period of time, be pastors. It is the faith and the life of holiness of the individual members of the community that make it a parish, a community of disciples. And John certainly was an example of that. I am grateful to the Holy Cross community for teaching me that lesson. It's been a good lesson for me to learn and to remember. The author of the Book of Wisdom says, "The souls of the just are in the hand of God." Picture John. He is that just man who now lives in the fullness of God's presence. He was a just man not simply in a sense of fairness, but he was a just man in the biblical sense of being in right relationship with God. For that's what biblical justice is. To be in a right relationship with the God who gave us everything there is, and then to be in right relationship with those of us in the human community. And John accomplished both. He certainly was a just man. And now he rests in the fullness of God's peace. There were challenges and bumps in the road during his life, but now all of that has disappeared. And he is in the light, the peace, and the glory of God's kingdom. The Gospel of Matthew has a wonderful excerpt that we just heard about the attentiveness that we are called to as disciples of Jesus, attentiveness to others' needs. Certainly, that also describes John. He was always aware of others around him, and he was attentive to them, not only in his gentle greeting and in his friendly chit-chat, but in his genuine care in prayer for all of them. And that is, I think, the greatest gift that your father, father-in-law, your grandfather, and great-grandfather passed on to all of you. Indeed, he saw those who needed to be assured of the presence of God in their life, and he was that presence for them. He gave them an awareness of God's incredible and inexhaustible love in all that he did. The other day, Steve and I traded text messages. And Stephen said in his text message to me how proud he was of the legacy of John and Loretta, how proud he was of the gift of that legacy that they left. And indeed, all of you are the beneficiary, the heir of that legacy.
He spoke caringly. He hurt when you were hurting. He was joyful when you were joyful. All proud. And for the record, I can name all 11. Without a cheat sheet, but not in birth order. That would be too much. But we start with Caring Carol. And we finish with Singing Steve. And in between, there is Judy, Jan. Let's pause for a prayer for Jan. Mary, Kathy, Jean, Anne, John Michael, Joe, Pat, and the singer. I'm not just another pretty face. I did it. The second reading is a reminder of the faith that John shared with all of us. As the years went on and his body diminished, he was aware that during those years he was preparing for what Paul tells the Corinthian church, that there is a building not made by human hands, but made by God, a building made to last for all eternity. That's the building that John now occupies. The building that had been made for him in heaven because of his long and faithful and dedicated life. So today, my friends, we celebrate this just man who rests in the fullness of God's peace. This man who, indeed, not only took care of himself, but so many others. A man whose dwelling is now permanent, eternal, in heaven. I think today is a day when we celebrate that John Francis has approached the gates of heaven. And next to Jesus to welcome him is Loretta, who said, "Finally, you're here." And Jesus says to John, "Come, my beloved, enjoy the place that had been prepared for you from the beginning of the world." Thank you to all of you for allowing me to be here this morning. Please know that you are in our hearts and our thoughts and our prayers as you adjust to these days without the physical presence of John. But know that he is in your heart, in your memories, in the wonderful stories you tell about him. God bless you.
Son, we pray.
Praise the Lord.
Many people people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray.
Praise the
Lord. Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray.
Praise the Lord.
For Francis, our Pope, Archbishop Samuel Aquila, and all men and women who dedicate their lives to the Catholic Church, we pray.
Praise the Lord.
For all military men and women who serve or who have served our nation so faithfully, we pray.
Praise the Lord.
The family and friends of John seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain, and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. We pray.
Praise the Lord.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother John. Strengthen our hope so that we may live the expectation of your son's coming. We pray.
Praise the
Lord. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant you a place in the kingdom. We ask this to Christ.
Cleanse me, Lord, of all my silly centuries.
Might be consoled by the promise of immortality to Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with crowns and dominions, and with all the host of powers of heaven, we sing a hymn of your glory, as with our end we acclaim.
With your servant Francis, our Pope, Samuel, our Bishop, all in the
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant John, who you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with Christ in his resurrection, when from the earth he will rise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you as your passing forth from this life, give kind indulgence to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you are God as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all which is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the same year's command, transformed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. I graciously grant you peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Yes,
let us offer each other the sign of peace. David and Anne, would you please come forward for communion?
I want to hear you say, I
Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you John, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto you, O Lord, and unto John, O Lord, and the perpetual light shine upon him. Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend John in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, John will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon John in this life. They are signs to us of your own goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to John and help us to remain so that we can comfort one another with assurances of faith until with John we all meet again in Christ and are with the Lord and John forever and ever.
Amen.
Fall on Jesus.
go in peace and let my glory shine. And fly to Jesus, fly to Jesus, fly to Jesus.
The death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death. Through his rest in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you, and through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayers for John and for all who have died in Christ and who are buried with him in the hope of rising again. Since they were true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. O God of mercy, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear us, your people, who cry out to you in our need, and strengthen our hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before our final prayer, we have a blessing of John and the grave, and so I'd like to invite all of the great-grandchildren who are here to come up and join me. All right, this water in here, this is water that came from the baptismal font at church. And so I brought some with me so that we can all bless Grandpa John, all right? So I'm gonna just, we'll just pass this around and each of you can take a minute and we'll just bless the body like this with a little bit of holy water, okay? All right. Oh my gosh. We better start with somebody tall, huh? Would you like to start? Hold up. behind me? Good job. That's great. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.